Today we shall reflect on the life of Saint Simeon. Saint Simeon, also known as Simon, the son of Cleophas, is called a brother of our Lord in the Gospels of Saint Matthew and Mark. As one of the 72 disciples, he was present at Christ's ascension and at the descent of the Holy Spirit at Pentecost. He is also thought to have been one of the two men whom Christ joined on the road to Emmaus after his resurrection. At Easter in the year 62, his brother Saint James the Less, the first bishop of Jerusalem, was killed by the Jews, and Simeon, who had not hesitated to reproach the Jews fearlessly for their action, was thereupon elected to succeed him. During his episcopate, a number of heretical sects sprang up, which denied the divinity of Christ and other fundamental truths, and so troubled the unity of the young church. In the year 66, God warned Simeon of the impending destruction of Jerusalem, and the bishop accordingly moved his faithful to Pella, some 65 miles away, on the opposite shore of the Jordan. 4 years later, Titus's army entered Judea in order to suppress the Jewish uprisings and laid siege to Jerusalem for 5 months before taking and destroying it in the year 70. As a result, some 600,000 Jews lost their lives, but the cenacle, which had been the scene of the Last Supper and the descent of the Holy Spirit, providentially escaped the general destruction and was later dedicated at the church. The Christian community and their bishop are believed to have returned to the ruined city and to have lived there until Adrian in the year 134 razed it completely to the ground. Saint Simeon was able to survive the persecutions of Vespasian and Domitian, when every descendant of the house of David was supposed to have been put to death. But in the year 112, when Trajan took up the persecution of the church, some Jewish heretics denounced Saint Simeon as a relative of Jesus and a Christian. He was thus imprisoned, most atrociously tortured for several days, and eventually crucified. He attained the venerable old age of about 120 years. With Saint Simeon's death, we arrive at the close of the so-called apostolic age, for he is believed to have been the last survivor of the disciples who had actually seen and conversed with our Lord.